day. Kindly follow me on my Facebook page and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you! Sa video tutorial na ito, pag-uusapan natin ang differential calculus, which involves the basic differentiation formulas part 1. At sa part 1 na ito, gagamitin natin ang unang anim na formulas in the basic differentiation. So, simulan na natin. Pero bago yun, ano nga ba ang calculus? Calculus is a branch of mathematics focused on limits, functions, derivatives, integrals, and infinite series. It is discovered by Isaac Newton of England and Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz of Germany. So, ang calculus ay binubuo ng ilang parts. So, simulan natin sa differential calculus. Ano ba ang differential calculus? It is a type of calculus that focuses on rates of change, such as slopes of tangent lines and velocities. Okay, proceed na tayo sa first rule or formula, that is the constant rule. And the formula for the constant rule is derivative of C with respect to X equals 0, wherein C is any constant o kahit anong number. So, for example, let us find the derivative first, Y equals 4. So, yung Y ay papalitan natin ng derivative of y with respect to x equals, let us now use the formula, since the given constant is 4, so magiging derivative of 4 with respect to x. So, yung 4 na ito, pwede nyong ilagay dito sa gitna or pwede din sa tabi ng d sa numerator. So, sabi dyan, kapag ang constant o when we are finding the derivative of any constant, the answer is always 0. Therefore, the derivative of 4 with respect to x is 0. Another example is y equals 28. Next is the derivative of y with respect to x or dy dx equals derivative of 28 with respect to x. So, since 28 is a constant, therefore the answer is also 0. Again, this is read as derivative of y with respect to x is equal to. So, ganyan po tayo magbabasa or in proper way ng given differentiation formulas. Second rule is the identity function rule. We have the formula derivative of x over dx or derivative of x with respect to x equals 1, wherein x is always equals to 1. So, example, find the derivative. We have the given y equals x. Yung y, papalitan natin ng dy over dx equals, i-insert na natin yung formula. So, magiging derivative of x, since x yung ating given, with respect to x, or d over dx times x. Again, yung x na ito na ating given ay pwede nyong itabi sa d sa numerator. So, therefore, the answer is 1. So, let us now proceed to the third rule, that is the constant identity function rule. Or, pinagsama ang constant rule at identity function rule. So, ito yung gagamitin nating formula. Let's have the example. Find the derivatives. Y equals 5x. Yung 5 natin, iyon yung constant. At yung x natin, iyon yung gagamitan natin or hahanapan natin ng derivative. So, that will be dy over dx equals 5 times the derivative of x with respect to x. Since the derivative of x is 1, so that the result will be 5 times 1 and then 5 times 1 is 5. So, that is the final answer. Another example, y equals 9x. Gamitan natin ng multiplication symbol para hindi tayo malilito sa paghihiwalay ng constant and variable. So, magiging dy over dx equals 9 times the derivative of x with respect to x. Again, the derivative of x is 1, so 9 times 1, the final answer is 9. The third rule is the sum or difference rule. And in this rule, we will use this given formula. So, kung mapapansin nyo, meron na tayong dalawang variables, which are the variable u and V. So, ito yung gagamitin natin formula. It's either in addition or in subtraction. So, we have the given example. Let us find the derivative of y equals 10x plus 4. So, yung 10x, iyon yung ating u, at yung 4, iyon yung v. Since walang sign na makikita dito, 4 is positive because this symbol is for the addition. So, let us now add or find the derivative. So, magiging dy over dx equals, hanapin muna natin yung derivative ng u. Since ang u ay 10x, let us find the derivative of 10x with respect to 10 to x plus finding the derivative of v. Since 4 is yung v, so let us find the derivative of 4 with respect to x. Okay, ano nga ba ang derivative ng 10x at ng 4? So the result will be derivative of 10x is 10 times the derivative of x plus 0. Paano naging 0 yung derivative ng 4? So since ang 4 ay constant has always the derivative of 0. Kung ito man ay 1,000 or 100, palagi pong 0 ang derivative nila. So ngayon, hanapin naman natin ang derivative ng x. So magiging 10 times 1 plus 0 because the derivative of x is 1. Okay, next is to get the final answer or the derivative. So the final answer is 10 because 10 times 1 is 10 plus 1 is 10. Another example for the sum or difference rule, we have the given y equals 21x minus 3x. So, hanapin natin ang derivative ng u at ng v. Ang u natin ang 21x at ang v ang positive 3x. And then, gagamitin natin yung difference rule since subtraction ang ating symbol. Kaya magiging dy over dx equals, lagyan natin ng bracket or open and close bracket para hindi tayo malito sa paggrupo or pagsasagot ng u and v. So, simulan natin sa finding the derivative of u. So, finding the derivative of 21x with respect to x minus the derivative of 3x with respect to x. Let us now find the derivatives of two given variables. So, ganito yung magiging sagot, 21 times derivative of x, or pwedeng idiretso nyo na 21 times 1, minus 3, which is the constant, times the derivative of x. Kaya magiging 21 times 1, minus 3 times 1. Igrupo natin ang mga numbers or ang mga terms para hindi kayo malito sa sagot. So let us now multiply 21 times 1 is 21, minus 3 times 1 is 3. So the derivative or the final answer is 18. Fifth step or fifth rule is the product rule. Kapag sinabing product, that is multiplication. So, gamitin natin ang formula na ito in applying the product rule. Meron pa rin tayong letters U and V. Okay, we have the given example. Find the derivative of y equals 6x times 4x. Ang 6x, iyon yung U, at ang 4x, iyon naman yung V. So, gamitin na natin yung formula para sa product rule, kaya magiging dy over dx equals, gamit ulit tayo ng bracket, so dun muna tayo sa u times dv over dx. So, ang u ay 6x times the derivative of v, which is yung 4x with respect to x, plus, yun yun nasa formula, plus 4, which is yung v, times derivative of 6x with respect to x. Ngayon, hanapin naman natin yung derivative ng 4x at derivative ng 6x. I-bring down lang natin yung 6x sa kaliwa at positive 4x sa kanan. Kaya magiging 6x times 4 because the derivative of 4x is 4 times 1 plus 4x, or i-bring down natin yung 4x times the derivative of 6x is 6. And then, let us now multiply the numbers. So, magiging 6x times 4 is 24x plus 4x times 6 is 24x also. Therefore, the final answer or the derivative is 48x. Another example for the product rule, let us find the derivative of y equals 3x minus 2 times x plus 5. Kung mapapansin nyo, parehong binomial ang ating given na u at v. Ganun pa rin yung gagawin natin sa formulas. So, let us find the derivative. So, magiging dy over dx equals, let us use the bracket since maraming constants or variables ang ating gagamitin sa solution. So, dun muna tayo sa u. U times derivative of v. So, u, ang u natin ay 3x minus 2 times derivative of x plus 5. Because iyon yung v natin. Plus, palagi po siyang plus. Dahil iyon yung nasa formula ng product rule, v, which is x plus 5, times derivative of 3x minus 2. Ibibring down natin dito ang 3x minus 2 sa kaliwa at x plus 5 sa kanan dahil ang hahanapan naman natin ng derivative ay ang x plus 5 at 3x minus 2. So, ang magiging result is 3x minus 2 times 1 plus 0. Paano naging 1 plus 0? The derivative of x is 1, and then the derivative of the constant 5 is 0. Plus, bring down x plus 5, the derivative of 3x is 3, and the derivative of 2 is 0. Okay, so let us now simplify. Simulan natin dito. So, magiging 3x minus 2 plus 3x plus 15. Because 1 times 3x is 3x. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. Plus, 3 times x is 3x and 3 times 5 is 15. Pwede na nating i-cancel yung 0 dito. Okay, so let us now combine like terms. Pagsamahin natin or isolve natin ang 3x plus 3x at negative 2 plus 15. So, the final answer for the derivative is 6x plus 13 because 3x plus 3x is 6x and negative 2 plus 15 is positive 13. Sixth rule is the quotient rule, and in quotient rule, we will use this given formula. So, let's have the example. Find the derivative of y equals 6x over 4x. Kapag may nakita kayong fraction, automatic ang gagamitin yung formula ay yung sa quotient rule. So, 6x here is the letter u and 4x is for the letter v. So, let us have the solution. Dy over dx equals, so again, gumamit tayo ng brackets para sa v times du over dx at u times dv over dx. So, dun muna tayo sa v. So, since ang v ay 4x, so let us just copy 4x times the derivative of u, which is 6x. Minus 6x times the derivative of 4x with respect to x all over v squared. So, since ang v natin ay 4x, so magiging 4x quantity squared. So, ngayon, hanapin na natin ang derivative ng 6x at ng 4x. So, kukopyahin lang natin yung 4x dito at 6x ng kanan. So, magiging 4x times 6 because the derivative of 6x is 6. Minus 6x times the derivative of 4x is 4. All over 4x quantity squared will be 16x squared. Because 4 squared is 16 and x squared is x squared. So, let us now multiply the binomials. So, magiging 4 times 6 is 24x. 4x times 6 is 24x minus 6x times 4 is 24x also, all over 16x squared. Next is to combine like terms. Since pareho silang may variable x, so let us subtract 24x minus 24x is 0. All over, kopyahin lang natin yung 16x squared. So, since 0 ang numerator, therefore the final answer is 0. Pero kapag ang 0 ay nasa denominator, the answer is undefined. Okay, another example for the quotient rule. We we have the given y equals 1 plus 2x over 1 minus 2x. 1 plus 2x here, or the numerator, is the letter u, and the denominator, that is 4v. So let us now have the solution. Dy over dx equals, use again, a brackets or any brackets para hindi tayo malito sa solution. So dun muna tayo sa v times du over dx. So since ang v natin ay 1 minus 2x, so kopyahin natin yung 1 minus 2x times the derivative of 1 plus 2x, o yung u natin with respect to x, minus 1 plus 2x, because that is the u, times the derivative of v, which is 1 minus 2x, all over v squared, so 1 minus 2x quantity squared. Kapag hindi tayo naglagay again ng open and close parenthesis, ang exponent na 2 ay mapupunta lamang sa 2x at wala siya sa 1. So, kailangan po kabilang yung 1 sa didistributan ng 2 mamaya. So, the result will be 1 minus 2x times the derivative of 1 is 0 plus derivative of 2 is 2x is 2. So, 0 plus 2 is positive 2, kaya hindi na natin nilagay ang 0 dito. And then, minus, copy, 1 plus 2x, and then derivative of 1, again, is 0. 0 minus 2 is negative 2. All over, just copy the denominator. Okay, next is to multiply 2 to 1 and negative 2, kaya naging 2 minus 4x. Because 2 times 1 is 2. 2 times negative 2x is negative 4x. Minus. Maglagay tayo ng open close parenthesis dahil negative o minus ang sign dito. Kapag hindi tayo naglagay ng sign o ng open close parenthesis, mag-iiba yung ating solution or mamamali tayo sa sagot. So, negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. Negative 2 times positive 2x is negative 4x all over the denominator. Next is, kailangan nating alisin yung open and close parenthesis by multiplying the negative sign dun sa dalawang sign. Kaya naging 2 minus 4x plus 2 plus 4x, and then copy the denominator. Okay, let us now combine like terms. Since parehong may variable x ang negative 4 at positive 4, so iyon yung i-combine natin. Negative 4x plus 4x is 0. So ika-cancel na lang natin yung parehong may variable x, so ang natira na lang ay 2 plus 2. So 2 plus 2 is 4 over the denominator. Therefore, the final answer is 4 over 1 minus 2x quantity squared. Or, pwede nyong i-distribute ang exponent sa 1 at sa negative 2x. So let us now summarize the first part of the basic differential formulas. For the constant rule, we have this given formula. Second is the identity function rule. Third is the constant or identity function rule, o yung pinagsamang constant and identity function. Third is the sum or difference rule. Fifth is the product rule. And the last, for the first part, is the quotient rule. Yan, sana ay may natutunan kayo sa unang part ng ating basic differential formulas. So, abangan nyo ang sunod na part o ang pangalawang part ng basic differentiation formulas. Thank you for watching. If you have questions or suggestions, feel free to comment below. Enjoy learning mathematics. God bless us all!